welcome to this episode of Trouble Bites. I'm Thomas Townley, coming to you from Studio K with the latest Star Trek news. If you're watching us live on sci-fi4me.2, you can chat with us live and give us your comments. And if you're watching the replay, feel free to leave a comment with your thoughts. Let's begin tonight with Star Trek Discovery. An article at RollingStone.com details the development of the show at CBS and includes a report that after showrunner and series creator Brian Fuller's departure from Discovery, co-executive producers Aaron Harberts and Gretchen Berg start to envision a slightly darker version of the usual Trek stories. The reason for that? Donald Trump. Harberts admits that the Trump phenomenon was, quote, front and center in our minds, unquote. He admits, when talking about the post-Fuller production process, quote, we felt it would be interesting to really look at what's going on in the United States, unquote. He mentions that among the show's antagonists are an ultra-religious and violent Klingon faction whose rallying cry, Remain Klingon, is intentionally reminiscent of the Trump slogan, Make America Great Again. In an interview with Business Insider, Harberts admitted the new Klingon factions are all about isolationism and racial purity. Rejecting the helping hand and taking care of self above others, saying, quote, that was pretty provocative for us, unquote. When we will link to these interviews in our show notes on our YouTube channel, Sci-Fi for Me TV. And as we've been noting in our social media, we here at sci-fi4me.com would like to remind you that we take no sides politically, left, right, or center. We all love good sci-fi. Sinequa Martin Green loves her character's name. This she reveals in an interview with CBS News. Quote, I love all of it, she said. I love having a male name, and I think that speaks to the gender fluidity of our future. I have been named after my biological father. So that's a sort of nod to the father-daughter dynamic on the show, unquote. Also, in an interview with Rolling Stone about taking on a role on Star Trek, I sort of bent under the weight of it at the beginning, quote, as she said. I just felt taking over and crushed underneath it. But I realized that's the wrong way of looking at this. I believe it's a story that will incite positive change, and so I want to put all of my focus and energy and passion into it. Martin Green also acknowledged that it's never been mentioned that Spock had a sister in previous iterations of the show, but she said that they're working on it and to be patient. Now, patience is a virtue, but a production delay is also a big help. Star.com reports that was a production delay caused by Brian Fuller's departure and the search for just the right person for the role of Michael Burnham that allowed Sinequa Martin Green to be able to accept the role, since it allowed the clock to run out on her Walking Dead contract. Quote, it was one door closing and another door opening almost simultaneously, Martin Green says. It was such a defined thing, I knew I was leaving The Walking Dead. It was sealed in stone. We were shooting the last few episodes and then this came, unquote. And still, we're asked for even more patience this time from Star Trek Discovery's EP, Aaron Harberts, who asked for patience with continuity changes. In an interview with CBR.com, Mr. Harberts explained why fans should be patient with the brand new Trek show and its continuity-bending story. When asked whether the series would address these crafty deviations from the main continuity, Harberts responded, quote, absolutely. I wish we could watch it with them on the couch. When something looks like it is wildly divergent from what people know to be canon, I always want to say, hold on a second, just wait, we know. He went on to explain that 9 times out of 10, they knew they were violating canon, and that 2 or 3 episodes later, they were going to turn it. He said that if people are patient and sort of don't have a knee-jerk reaction to what they're seeing, the delight has been resolving it, tying it up, showing everybody that we're in on it. So, do you agree? Should we just hold our collective horses and wait until the story is finished before we start hitting the panic button on change continuity? Let us know. And What about that mature rating that the series has been given? Harbert, in a separate interview, noted, quote, "So if you're going to do something like language or a little nudity or a little extra violence, which that's one of the sad things about where we are in terms of media, violence is accepted. Sexuality, maybe not so much," he said. "We're taking great pains to make sure that nothing feels gratuitous if we're doing it, and that if language is involved, it might be language that's celebratory," unquote. In the article, he also showcased a moment where the F-bomb was dropped by Cadet Tilly and Anthony Rapp's character, which I won't report on here, truly. Let's just say that the F-word and cool are used. He went on to say that, quote, "So in a moment like that, where I feel like we're celebrating smarts and people who are at the top of their game, it's rare when we'll do it. But if we do it, we want to make it feel organic," unquote. So, what do you think of the mature rating on Discovery? Will you skip the series because of it? And should they have a censored version available for those who don't want too much sex, violence, and language? Please tell us in the comments section. Now, did you notice anything interesting in the background of the Discovery premiere? The cast and crew of Star Trek Discovery puts nods to the past Star Trek series all over the show. You might have noticed use of classic sounds in the background peppered throughout the show. How about that bottle of Chateau Picard in Captain Georgiou's ready room? Or the Tribble on Lorca's desk? There are plenty of references to other Trek. Now, what have you noticed? And do you have a favorite so far? Please let us know. Now, the ratings are in for the one and only episode of the new series that we will likely see on broadcast on national TV. Since the rest of the series and on CBS All Access, we're unlikely to get any kind of numbers on its viewership from here on out. Now, Discovery received a 1.9 rating and a 7 share with adults 18-49 and attracted an audience of 9.6 million viewers for its live plus same day rating. Now, comparing that to Discovery with Fox's The Orville live plus same day rating only, The Orville received a 2.3 with an 8 share and attracted an audience of 7.32 million. So they're about on par with each other. Now, true, the Discovery's numbers aren't final yet, but we have yet to receive a number for the live plus 7 day total. Please, we'll keep you informed when we receive those numbers. New Yorkers got to see a real life USS Discovery in the skies over Manhattan the night before the premiere. Okay, well, it was an illusion put together via LED lights attached to a truss being carried by a Black Hawk helicopter. Or was it the real, or is that what they wanted you to think, and the real Discovery was up there? Now, CBS reports record sign-ups for CBS All Access, but this next piece of news might see a record number of people quitting All Access for a while. After the series finale, season finale. It looks like season two will not be out at all until 2019. Quote, "Ideally on the early side of 2019," unquote, producer Alex Kurtzman told The Hollywood Reporter when asked when we might see season two hitting the airwaves. He told THR that there have been preliminary conversations about when and how a second season could air. And we've been very consistent in our message, which is that rather than announce a date and have to push again, let's take into consideration everything we've learned from this season. He also went on to say, quote, "We want to take the right amount of time and we don't want to rush." Kurtzman also went on to confirm that only the first four episodes are fully complete at present, with the fixed fifth in the mixing stage. As for the production, shooting is now underway on the final two episodes of the season. Now, there's also been some casting news for Discovery. Mia Kirshner, also known for her role as Jenny Schechter on the cable series The L Word, as well as the sci-fi series Defiance, will play Spock's mother, Amanda, in the future episode. Now, we've seen Sarek, we've seen Amanda. Still, could we see Spock? What do you think those odds are? Please let us know in the comments. On to some other news about our other favorite Star Trek-like series, The Orville. Things are looking good for the series on Thursday nights. For the Star Trek-inspired episode, If the Stars Should Appear, the show came in second behind the return of Will and Grace on NBC with a 1.1 and a 4 share with 3.7 million viewers, a big uptick from its lead-in of Gotham, which only received a 0.9 and a 3 share with only 2.87 million viewers. It's not dead yet, folks. CBR.com has also come out with a comparison of The Orville and Star Trek Discovery. They note that The Orville is done in the classic Trek TV format with very low continuity between episodes, while Discovery is a tightly woven single story. The Orville spends time developing all of its cast, while Discovery seems to focus on a few characters while the rest of it aren't as fleshed out. The article also notes that the characters on The Orville would not be Roddenberry approved, as they have conflicts with each other and personal issues. Discovery, on the other hand, has more mature characters, more in line with Roddenberry's vision of the future. Personally, I like the Orville and its version of the future. There's a lot less flair. For this next story, you might want to mute your Amazon Echoes and Dots. I'll give you a second. So, do you have an Amazon Echo? And if you do, then you have some new skills and questions to ask Alexa. Now, when you want to update an update on weather, news, and other daily information, you can say, Alexa, or computer, damage report. Also, Alexa can also deliver sound effects from the original show if you use the following commands. Red alert, blink, beam me up, or blink, fire photon torpedoes. Alexa will also entertain fans with her answers to the following requests or questions. Blink, speak Klingon.
I don't know that.
Blink, what would Scotty say? Blink, revenge is the dish best served cold. Or you can say blink, what is your mission? Blink, state Starfleet rank and class. Blink, what would Dr. McCoy say? Or blink, do you trust Klingons? And if you think you know your Star Trek trivia, try Alexa, open Star Trek, and prepare to show off your knowledge. For more information,
here's what I found.
Alexa, stop. For more information, check out the link in our show notes. So what do you think makes a good Star Trek series? If you have asked former Star Trek producer Ron Moore, Star Trek is a show of little morality plays. He recently said this when he spoke with denofgeek.com. He is also now a fan of the action-adventure bent that the movie franchise has brought to the Star Trek universe. Quote, there are some good space battles in some of the later series, but that wasn't why you were tuning in every week. You were tuning in every week because Spock was a fascinating character, because his friendship with Kirk was profound and really unusual. The triangle with McCoy was a really interesting thing, and Data as Pinocchio tries to be a real boy is a great storyline. And Worf's story as a Klingon among humans and Picard's relationship with Q, and, you know, the politics of Deep Space Nine and terrorism and occupation, unquote. Now, I couldn't agree more with Ron Moore. What do you think? Please, leave a message in the comments section. And now, let's turn to some merchandising news. Did you take a look at those cool badges on the uniforms on Star Trek Discovery? Would you like one like this? Then head on over to QMX Online and pick up yours today. They cost $14.95 and come in Operations, Science, Command, and have a strong magnetic back that won't damage your clothes, like this. Pretty cool, huh? Now, if you're getting that badge, why not get that uniform as well? Enovos.com, the official uniform licensee, is releasing screen-accurate uniforms for you to wear. All three divisions are represented, Command Gold, Science Silver, and Operations Copper, and they are available in both men and women's sizes from small to 2XL. Now, this uniform will set you back. The Discovery uniform will cost you $500 and will ship in summer of 2018. Now, do you plan on buying a Discovery uniform, or are you attempting to make your own? Please let us know and be sure to upload your pics and send them to us, and we'll post them on our Pinterest feed. Now, would you like to know more about Takuma before he ran into Michael Burnham and the rest of the fleet? Then your prayers have just been answered by IDW's four-part Discovery comic series written by Mike Johnson. We'll be getting a prequel starring Takuvma and how and why he ended up where he ended up. Mike said in an interview that this story stays strictly on the Klingon side of things and would give their perspective of the Federation. He also said that this is a great opportunity to show that the Klingons are not villains, but a species with their own civilization filled with individuals with their own dreams, ambitions, and vendettas. Now, have you ever wanted to play with the Discovery crew? Star Trek Timelines has launched a new update that integrates Star Trek Discovery into its universe. According to Disruptor Beam, the new Discovery characters, ships, crew, and storylines will be making their way into Star Trek Timelines as the series airs. Players will get a sneak peek at this new Discovery content starting this week with an updated introductory storyline featuring Commander Michael Burnham and Lieutenant Saru. Thursday, October 5th, we'll kick off a month-long mega event called Discovery, a New Anomaly. The mega event will consist of four individual weekend events and give you such crew as Captain Philippa Georgiou, Gabriel Lorca, and Harry Mudd. And while you're playing games, hop into Star Trek Online right now. You only have a few days left to get your Next Generation 30th anniversary goodies. You can pick up your scant dress, your scant uniform, as seen in season one of The Next Generation, and the Type 7 shuttle absolutely free. All you have to do is go to the Promotions tab in the Seas store and get them for your characters. And also, just today, the new season of Star Trek Online launched. Season 14, Emergence, features a new colony fleet holding, a new featured episode titled Melting Pot, the Miracle Worker specialization, a new ground queue and Red Alert queue, and a new Zenkethi lockbox. And if you'd like to play with me while I'm on Star Trek Online, please find me at BrimstoneXO in the game. I'd love to see you there. Now, that's it for this episode. Be sure to watch all our other shows and video gameplay on Twitch and YouTube, and check out our website at scififorme.com, and we're on all the social media. And if you're a subscriber, be sure to share with us, with your friends, and if you're brand new to the show, please be sure to subscribe. Until next time, thanks for watching Tribble Bytes. Live long and prosper.